Right, here's the chapter two. Let me just get that in a good position. Yeah, right. Now, at the moment, you've got a bolt a little bit like this, the way they fitted it. And you've got this tool here, and you'll see that it's basically in two pieces. It's got this outer bit here which swivels, and the other bit swivels inside it. And somewhere on the tool you'll see there will be a little hexagon thing there, like a little socket. And that you use to put in there. And then you will need a spanner of some sort, of which I'm sure you've got, just to put on there, and you undo the bolt which holds your crank arm. Okay. Now this is the fun bit. Very simple. You just take that out there and put that somewhere where it's not going to get lost. Now inside here you'll see, up the middle, you'll see the square peg thing. There's a square hole. Now what we do is, I hope you can still see it. Yes, you can. Then what we do is we get this tool here, and we make sure that this is not sticking out. You see, as I'm screwing it up, it's going through there. This bit drives the middle stem out, so when you turn it. So what you do is you just turn that right back there, so it's just sort of sitting flat, and then we take this big bit of thread and we screw it very carefully. You have to make sure it goes in nice and straight, and you screw it in as far as it goes. Okay, then what we do is we take this bit here and we screw that up until it goes tight, and then we get another spanner, and then we, and you may well find this takes a little bit of wear. You hold the, I hope you can see what I'm doing here. Let's have a look here. You hold the pedal in position, or the crank if you've taken the pedal off, so it doesn't keep turning round. And you turn that, and it'll be very stiff, like this, and you basically turn this until it goes loose. You'll find that it just goes way like this, and this just comes off. Okay. Then what we do is you have to then unscrew this from there, like that. That's how it goes. Now, when you want to put the new one on, you screw your pedal onto the new crank arm, and then you just basically make sure you get it on the right way, not so that the both pedals are facing the same way. That would be quite funny. And you just basically lightly insert this back onto there and just push it as far as it will go with your hands, and you'll find it's sort of wobbly to begin with. Then what you do is you get your hexagon socket bolt. I've not got my one, as you can see, I've got one of these, this sort, like they put in. This is the more usual one, but the ones you've got are much more convenient, a bit more advanced technologically. And you just screw it in, and using an Allen key, you know, one of those Inbus wrenches, you screw it up, and screwing it up draws the, I'm using the same one as I did before, it draws the taper slightly cornish, like this. And you have to do it pretty tight, actually. Let's do that. Now, the mistake I made with yours was not to tighten it up properly. I just did it sort of once, like that. And you really have to do them up very tight indeed, because what happens if you don't do them tight, as I explained to you before, what can happen is these things can sort of rattle loose. As you tread on them, it causes a little bit of movement, and that little bit of movement can hammer the soft, this material here is made of aluminium, and that can be hammered with every pedal stroke, can hammer out the shape, the square peg, the square hole out, so it's no longer square, it becomes slightly rounded out, and then it no longer screws up tight. But once you've done that, that's basically all there is to it. Right, now, I don't know whether that's any good. I'm going to load this up to YouTube now. There's two bits of it. I think that's all you need to know. I think that pretty well covers everything. So I will, check it through, load it up to YouTube, and then you can have a go at it yourself. It's dead easy to do that kind of thing.